In this video, we will learn how to add a logical camera to our factory simulation. And since our simulation uses a Gazebo simulator, let's understand some basic concepts of Gazebo world files first. A world file is used to create simulation models that can be used in the Gazebo physics simulator. The models are defined using the simulation description format, or SDF in short. And we can compose our simulation world as a combination of multiple SDF models. Notice here the similarity to URDF models we learned in week 2. The difference is there are more features possible with SDF models as opposed to the URDF models, such as we can add additional properties to a model like friction and also include non-robotic elements like spotlights, camera, the sun, a green field, and any real-world component that you want to model as a part of your robotic environment. And the nice thing is, the SDF and URDF models can be used together, as we are doing in this course, with some minor modifications. For seeing URDF models in Gazebo, we can use the spawner ROS node provided by the Gazebo ROS package that comes with your course installation. Another aspect with Gazebo simulations is that the actual functionality of the models we add can be also configured as per our needs via Gazebo plugins. For example, for the logical camera, we will use the logical camera plugin. The Gazebo SDF models we will use in our factory simulation reside in the hrwros_gazebo package, specifically in the models folder. Accordingly, the logical camera model files reside in the logical_camera folder. And we will also have to pick up objects from the conveyor belt. The different objects we want to pick up from the conveyor belt are configured in the conveyor_objects.yaml file in the config folder of the hrwros_gazebo package. In this course, we will only pick up one simple box object, but other objects are also provided from the Gilbreth and Ariac projects we have used as the basis to build our simulation. So, when you are doing your assignments, just modify this file to include other objects as well and see them appear on the conveyor belt in different poses, just for fun. So, here is an overview of the different models we can or have used in the factory simulation. We have the conveyor model, the deletion wall model, and the logical camera model. The first two are already used, and the logical camera is what you will add in your assignments. And here, we have an overview of a few plugins that we will use to achieve the desired functionality of our models. So, let's take a quick sneak peek at the factory simulation world file defined in the hrwros.world file. We see our world has a name called hrwros_world. And then, with the include tag in SDF, we can add SDF models to our world. Here is how the conveyor is added. And all of you will be adding the logical camera model here with the correct pose and orientation such that it appears as we saw in the previous video. Not only one, you will add two of them. One near the second robot for planning the pick pose of the object, which will be on the turtle bot. Good. In the next video, we will have an illustration where we will explore some of the components of the hrwros_gazebo package, particularly the logical camera model, to understand how to configure it for use in our ROS application.